It is time for me to review the Apple Card 1 year later. Now this is my third or fourth video talking about the Apple Card, and as you guys know, I absolutely love the Apple Card. I'm happy I got it, but I'm gonna be answering the question, should you apply in 2020? We're gonna find out right now. When I first signed up for the Apple Card, it was very simple, 1, 2, 3. You open up the wallet application on your iPhone, you tap the plus, you tap on Apple Card, you enter in your credentials to check for credit. Apple gave me a $5,000 credit limit, and I'm definitely grateful for that. I was able to purchase my MacBook, an iPhone, an Apple Watch. Now, it is gonna be a hard inquiry because you are applying for a credit card. And yeah, even though it's a hard inquiry and decrease your credit score, it could actually improve your credit score in the long run. So it's definitely important to get yourself new lines of credit. Especially if you're young, you still want to use your credit card responsibly because you don't want to get yourself into no kind of trouble. The Apple Card doesn't have any fees whatsoever, so there's no late fees, there's no foreign fees, no fees. Any fees you can think of, there's no fees whatsoever on the Apple Card. You don't even have any annual fees. And did I mention the card is made out of titanium? I actually love the cash back. Now, a lot of people have been complaining and, oh, it's not that much percent that you're getting back, but hey, you were getting 3% cash back from Apple, Uber, Uber Eats, Exxon, Mobil, Nike, T-Mobile, Walgreens, and the list just goes on. I'm pretty sure Apple is going to add in more partners in terms of the cash back. And also, you're getting 3% cash back on all of Apple services. So that is the in-app purchases, Apple Music, any Apple subscription service, iCloud, Apple TV Plus, Apple Arcade. You're getting 3% cash back. And then you get in 2% cash back anytime you use Apple Pay. So make sure you have your Apple Card linked up with Apple Pay. So I use that pretty much all the time if there's Apple Pay available. And you get a 1% cash back if you use your card physically, which I don't recommend doing that. Well, for me, it doesn't make sense for me doing that because I have better credit cards that offer way better benefits if I use my physical card. But it is pretty badass to use this card and give somebody this card because the feel of this card is so premium. And it's made out of titanium. It feels satisfying giving somebody this card. But you gotta be aware of those benefits. You only get 1% cash back. And trust me, cash backs makes a big difference. So use your card responsibly and wisely. And one thing too, you're getting fast cash back. So no need to wait a month or 2 months for it to clear. You're getting that cash back literally the next day. So once you do that transaction that same day, you get that cash back the next day. And this is real cash. Like, there's no gimmicks, there's no points. And you can actually send that cash to your debit card, or you can send that money to a friend, family, whatever the case may be. But I just like to save up all of my cash backs. I just don't like touching it. I like to use that for emergencies. If I need to, you know, spend $300 or something, I have that money right there in the tuck. Now, what I see Apple doing, I think they're gonna offer some kind of Apple Card Plus. Tylosa Tech made a video talking about this. Apple Card Max, you hear what I'm saying? I think they're gonna offer something like that, but it's gonna have an annual fee, but you're gonna have more benefits. But so far, I'm happy and satisfied with my Apple Card. Also, Apple introduced Apple Finance with no interest. So now you can buy an iPhone and pay it off within 24 months, no interest. So if I go out and buy an iPhone 11, for example, there's gonna be a monthly payment. It varies on your configuration of the iPhone, the storage. And I think that's gonna make things a little bit more easier to buy Apple products because you can finance it with no interest. And with the Mac, that's very convenient, or the XDR display or the HomePod or AirPods. It makes buying Apple products a whole lot easier. But either way, keep in mind, you're still paying that price. It's just spread out a little bit within a year or 2 years. And also, if you have multiple installments, so let's say you buy an iPhone, you buy AirPods and you buy a MacBook, you will have to pay off your balance first on your Apple Card in order to put money towards the installment on your Apple products. So if you spend $1,000 on an iPhone and then you went out shopping $100 on groceries or whatever the case may be, you spend $100, let's say you want to pay the $1,000 first on your installment, Apple is not going to let you do that. You have to pay off your Apple Card balance. So you have to pay off that $100 before you put money towards your monthly installment. But either way, they're going to charge you every month, whatever the monthly payment is going to be. And especially whoever likes to keep their iPhones and not give them up every year, like the Apple Upgrade Program, The Apple Finance is something I've been waiting for a very long time. And I knew Apple was going to do it. It was just a matter of time. Even though there's no late fees or there's no fees, interest is pretty high on this card. And one thing I like, Apple actually shows you how much interest you're paying. So it's a nice, easy to read graph that they show you. And you know, you're going to see how much interest you're paying. But for me, throughout the year, I paid off my balance every single month. If I spend $1,000 on something, I guess I'm paying $1,000 on my Apple card. That's what I always do. Never carry a balance the best as you can, because the interest, I hate paying interest, because why pay more when I could just pay for the whole thing right then? You know what I'm saying? That's just me. But not everybody's like that. And that leads me, Apple has introduced the COVID-19 skip month payment without interest. So this has been going on for like 4 or 5 months. And I gotta say, props to Apple for allowing the customers to do this, because due to COVID-19, people lost their jobs, you have unemployment, so it's gonna be a little bit harder for some people to pay off their Apple card, so you can pay whatever how much you want without interest. But for me, this doesn't really affect me too much, because I'm paying my entire balance every single month, and yeah, I wanna maintain my credit score. Finally, Apple allow us to pay off our Apple card online. So before, if you wanna pay off your Apple card, you have to either use the app on your iPhone, or you can call or text Apple and tell them that you wanna pay off your Apple card. And it's crazy, because you can't even pay off your Apple card on your iPad. You have to use an iPhone. Although I'm not really a huge fan of the interface online, I prefer the iPhone version because, well, it's more polished. This is kind of like the first stage of it. You know, to be able to text Apple any problem you have or you have any concerns, you could text Apple, get a response instantaneously. I know it's a robot at first, but once you tap on that connect, boom, you connect into a live agent. You just text an Apple. You could go about your business. You're not placed on hold or anything weird like that. You know, you're getting that fast support 24/7. Absolutely love that. That's one of my favorite things about the Apple Card. Now, mostly all of my purchases used on the Apple Card, I'm gonna be honest with you guys, it's just all about food. Food, drinks, it's just, I use that on my Apple Card. Cause you know, most places take Apple Pay, so I'm like, why not? I use my watch, sometimes I use my phone, and it's just so cool and so futuristic, and especially what's going on now with COVID. You don't even wanna give somebody your credit card and then, you know, you get it back and then it's germs on their gloves. Just, it's so much secure and clean to use Apple Pay. Just use your phone, bloop, authenticate, and you're done. You're walking out the door, and that's it. And you're getting that cash back too, that 2% cash back. So it's even better too. So let's say you buy something using your Apple card, and you decide you want to return it, and you receive your cash back already. What's going to happen is, when you return that product, you get your money back, but you're gonna get something called a daily cash adjustment. So whatever cash back that Apple gave you for that purchase is gonna charge your card that cash back. Which basically, you know, they still, like, you still have it on your daily cash card, so you could use that daily cash card to pay it off on your Apple card. You're not gonna be able to just spend $10,000 on the iMac Pro and then get, you know, $200 cash back and then, you know, and then you keep it. You're gonna have to pay that money back to Apple. Now this is how my Apple card looks right now. It looks pretty clean. There's no scratches, there's no scrapes. A little smidge on the swiping side, a little smidge scratches, but it's still overall in mint condition. And if it turns into crap at any time, I can launch up the wallet application and I can request a brand new credit card and Apple's gonna send it to me for free. I never requested for no replacement. This is the original Apple card from 2019. So yeah, I'm gonna be keeping this, and it still has that satisfying titanium sound. And overall, this is the most secure credit card that I ever own. It doesn't have any credit card numbers. In order for you to use that credit card number, you have to launch up the wallet application. But there was one problem with that. When I was ordering Domino's pizza, they needed to step it up and have Apple Pay on their app. Yeah, they wanted to see the credit card, but they're looking at the card like, where's the credit card number? Because a lot of scams and frauds going on, so they want to see the credit card just to authenticate. And yeah, they was looking around. Oh, I gotta call my boss. It was a big deal. That's how secure the Apple card is, because there's no credit card numbers here. So it's nothing to verify that, you know, that this is the credit card that I use, you know what I mean? And I even told the guy that you know, this is an Apple card. You guys never heard of an Apple card? To them, this is new, but, you know, to me, this is like, you know, the Apple card came out like a year ago. Mind you, this was 2020. This was this year. They just said, you know what, have your pizza. I ended up calling them back just to let them know that there's no scam going on. There's nothing going on. That's just how the card is. You know, I even told the guy that here's the app. You know, I use the app. That's how I get the credit card number. But they, you know, they don't trust nothing. I'm not capping here. I've been using it ever since August of 2019, and all the way up here, we get into August again. It's still July now, but hey, we approaching into the 1 year of the Apple Card, and I gotta say, it's one of my favorite credit cards to date. Also, you have a map on where you purchase that item. It's like nothing comes close to the Apple Card when it comes down to the interface of the portal. So yeah, do I recommend the Apple Card? I would say yes. If you love Apple and you buy Apple products every single year like me, this is definitely going to be a great card to have in your wallet. But yeah, only get the Apple Card if you know you're responsible of handling credit cards. This is a grown man's thing. This could ruin your life or this could improve your life. Because I know Apple products are very expensive, especially if you buy like an iPad, where you got to get the Apple Pencil, the Magic Keyboard, then you want to buy a MacBook. It can get a little crazy. So definitely, you want to use your card responsibly. So if you guys have any questions or concerns about the Apple Card, let me know down in the comments down below. I'll answer them. And other than that, this video is a wrap. That's my comprehensive review of the Apple Card 1 year later. And yeah, make sure you guys subscribe with notifications on. Follow me on Instagram and on Twitter at Simply Pops. And other than that, I hope you guys have a simple day. Stay safe, stay clean. Peace out.